Today, on the Global Hand Washing Day, I welcome you all from Dewan Hospital and other doctors and patients on this special day. This day, held on every 15th of October globally, was started in 2008, and this is 10 years, full one decade now. And so we are holding this seminar today, that your health in your hands, especially your own hands. So today I am delivering this talk, that your health in your hands, from the point of view of Global Hand Washing Day, that what are the importance of washing your hands and what can be the harms of not washing your hands, and what diseases you can prevent by washing your hands properly and frequently, and what diseases can happen if you don't wash your hands properly and frequently. So this is the slogan today: wash away germs and remain healthy. So our hands are always a procedure is there than when we eat food, we break the bread, mostly in India with our own hands. In South India, they use the hands to eat rice and rasam and other things and eat like this. We also don't eat rice with our hands, but we take chapati with our hands and use vegetable and put to our hands. As such, sometimes we put our hand to cut our nail or to take out something from our teeth. So basically, we keep on touching when we open doors, on the desk we sit, and when we touch our mobile or computer every minute, people are using mobiles. So this is full of bacteria. Computer desk is full of bacteria. Every place is full of bacteria. Especially in a hospital setup, the patients come. They are suffering from illnesses, they have wounds. So this is a very important thing to know, how to keep yourself healthy by avoiding those bacteria and germs, and how not to transmit diseases from one person to another. Like, I should myself remain healthy, and also I should not transmit disease from me to you. For example, I touch anything, we shake hand with anybody, so the bacteria, fungi, other things can get transmitted. So in this, that do not avoid washing hands thinking that it is not important. Don't think it is not important. You may realize it the hard way after bacteria, viruses, fungi and parasites are introduced in your body through your own hands, and illness grips your life. So if you don't realize it early, you may realize it late when you fall ill. Like, you keep seeing here patients with typhoid, patient with tuberculosis, diarrhea, dysentery. So never forget to wash away the dangerous germs from your hands. Now, Global Health Washing Day was started in 2008 when about 120 million children around the world washed their hands with soap in 70 countries. So this is a special day in which we try to give the knowledge, take the knowledge, share the knowledge with everyone. Like, you are now listening, this is learning, and learning is better if you teach. Like, I have learned, I am teaching. Now you learn, you teach to someone. When you go to your homes, you meet your friends, your relatives whom you love, whom you have respect and relation, you tell them, this is good for your health. If you are convinced, you tell them. This day is to spread the awareness about the potential risks of not washing hands routinely and the benefits of washing the hands. The theme for 2018 about the Global Hand Washing Day theme is Clean Hands, a Recipe for Health. You know, understand the meaning of recipe. Recipe is to make special dishes, like a cake, a soup, a vegetable, anything. So that is the recipe. So how we can be healthy? What are the ingredients which we put in a recipe, and how do we put them? That is a recipe, and that is clean hands. So clean hands, our hands which are clean, they are a recipe for a health. This is the theme of Global Hand Washing Day. The idea is to focus on the link between hand washing and food and nutrition. This year's theme reminds to make hand washing part of every meal. So this theme especially has been kept, that we during meals, at least during meals, when we take meals, I'll tell you when to wash your hands and when not to wash your hands, okay? So when you take meals, before that you wash your hands. So this is, many diseases are there which are called fecal-oral route, that is from feces. They, diseases from feces, latrine, you know, stools, they come to the mouth. So main things, how the things come to the mouth are that there are, one is touch, finger. Number two are flies, makhiyan. Number three is water. And number two is food. And so these all things, fingers, flies, fluid, food, and outside garden and other places, floor. So they are transmitted through the hand contamination with various infections which are passed in feces. Infections and infestation from feces are carried to hand under the nails. So they can be carried under the nails. This problem is very relevant in India scenario, since a large number of population washes the buttocks after defecation using water and their hands. You see, in India, most of the people, when they go for early to freshen up, so they don't have that automatic system of water shower, or they don't use towel, toilet papers. They have the water pitcher with which they wash their thing. After passing the stools or latrine, they wash with the hands. So before, you know, we have now water showers. We sit on an English seat and we have pass it and we have shower. Before that, we also used to do the same. So the stools, they all come into our hands and they have many bacteria and other things. So this is also, this is relevant in Indian scenario, as a significant number of population is going to open defecation, which can see while traveling through train in the morning. So I, when traveled in the train in the morning, I see many people sitting there and freshening up themselves, passing stools and latrine by the side of the railways and in the fields. So this way, they don't have again showers there. They are washing with their hands, and the stool which they pass there, the flies come because it's a food for them, hot food for them. And they sit there, and after sitting there, the flies go and sit on the homes, in the vegetable, fruits, on the food, on the places like, say, this is a table. Fly will sit here and will carry from the stools the bacteria and other things, infections here. And when I touch it, I will get it on my hand. These are microscopic organisms. I cannot see. I think my hands are clean. They are not clean. So open defecation attracts flies, and open defecation, not stressing air properly after touching the potential area of contamination, as I have explained to you. So why the list of, I am going to give you the list of various diseases which can spread through the fecal-oral route, from the hands, from the feces, to the mouth of a person. Either your mouth or the persons who are cooking the food, like in the market, you go to eat various things, you know, on the stalls. So those people also can transmit through the food to you many type of disease. Diarrhea. Diarrhea means loose stools. So many people, I think there is nobody in India who must not have suffered from diarrhea. I will not go into details of the bacteria causing diarrhea, what type of bacterial infection can. Dysentery. What is the difference between diarrhea and dysentery? Anyone? What is the difference between diarrhea and dysentery? Anyone? When you have blood or mucus with the loose stools, this is called dysentery, okay? So when the intestine gets wounded and there is bleeding from the intestine, so this is called dysentery. Cholera. You must have heard ki cholera, people used to die of cholera. Many massive loose stools, watery loose stools. The patient's all fluid, electrolyte, salt goes away in the stool. Patient loses fluid and patient's blood pressure falls, patient may die. And cholera outbreaks are taking place even now. Typhoid, we are seeing typhoid bacteria, paratyphoid, pseudomembranous enterocolitis. This is a very dangerous type of infection of the large intestine. Hepatitis A, hepatitis E, poliomyelitis. You know the people with the shrunken legs and all, small hands, poliomyelitis. that infection that goes to a nerve and the swelling, polio cases, you know, amoebiasis. So protozoal infections causing amoebiasis, again, a lot of mucus, maybe blood and multiple stools. Amoebiasis, giardiasis. So amoeba, just like a protozoal infestation, infection, there is giardia as a different organism like amoeba, and it also causes pain in the stomach, swelling of the stomach, loose stools. Cryptosporidiosis and toxoplasmosis, tapeworms. I have seen many patients bringing long worms, meter long worm. Sometimes they put it on the thread. A lady came that she kept on rolling the thread on a matchstick and the worm was very long. She brought in a bottle. Tapeworms. Then roundworms, ascaris. That is very common, especially in the hills where water is not clean. So ascaris, the worms are carried to the hand. So roundworms. Hookworms. They can go through the foot, but they can go through hand also sometime. And they suck the blood and patient becomes anemic. Pinworms, that is a small whitish worms. So from hand to hand, now this is from fecal route. That is from the stools to the mouth. Now second is from hand to hand. Now following disease can be prevented by breaking the chain that transmits dangerous disease by hand contamination from the source other than feces, right? So you may be spreading or receiving germs when you shake hands or touch anybody or anything, even your mobile phone. Now this, other than feces, is very, very relevant to our hospital setup, patient setup. Because we touch the patients, patients come and touch the things, like a patient who is of tuberculosis, maybe he's coughing like this. So he has the germs here, he comes and opens the door, and we open the same door from the same handle. So handle, patient to hands, hands to handle, handle to our hands, and hands to us, or to the hands of another patient, and then it goes like there. So what are the common diseases like that? Common cold, flu, influenza, which can be dangerous. There can be very serious flu infection, chicken pox, measles, conjunctivitis. There are many times epidemics or pandemics, you know, akha matlab ki lal ho jandi hai, red eyes and watering eyes. So conjunctivitis. Epstein-Barr virus, this is called a kissing disease, basically diagnosed in England because when it was more common in both the couples who are kissing, but it can be through contamination through hands, it can go. Tuberculosis, skin infections and infestations like viral warts, scabies. So now all other diseases which can come through fecal load, because the person's hand is contaminated with stools or feces, and you shake hands or you touch, he touches the table and you touch it. So the feces are there, which the patient has not washed the hands properly. So those can come through hand-to-hand contact also. So now we will discuss the proper method of hand washing. See, hand washing is very effective to save yourself from such serious diseases. You have seen in tuberculosis, intestinal tuberculosis, bone tuberculosis, brain tuberculosis, pericardial tuberculosis. Tuberculosis can occur anywhere. Then typhoid, intestines can perforate, gallbladder can perforate, there can be bleeding, patient may have high fever, dysentery. I have enumerated all the diseases which are very dangerous. So this is very effective hand washing. You must know you can prevent all these diseases. And this is simple procedure. This is very easy and this is not costly. This is easily affordable. And this can save you from lot of pain, loss of working hours. Anybody who gets ill, for example, gets chicken pox, measles, pain, uncomfortable, and you cannot go to work, right? So you lose money, you lose working hours, and sometimes the serious disease, one may die and lose or loss of life. So there are various tips for the proper hand washing. Number one, that plain hand washing is not effective. And it is better to wash your hands with a soap. Still better from a soap solution that you take from a bottle soap solution and wash your hands. And it is not necessary to have antibacterial soap solution. So second is that when you should wash your hands. So number one, when you go to toilet, you get to freshen up. After that, you must hand, you wash your hands properly. Or you change nappies of any patient, any person in the home, child or anyway. Then before and during and after preparing food. So when you prepare food, you cook your food. For example, you make dough, you cut vegetables, you cook food. Whenever you, before that, you properly wash your hands. And after that also you wash your hand. Before eating, I already told you. And after using a handkerchief, because these all handkerchiefs, toilet papers and all tissue papers, they are full of bacteria. So before and after attending to any patient. Before attending means you should wash away your bacteria. And after attending means you should wash away her or his bacteria or the patient. What you have got from patient, wash it away. First wash it away, what do I have here? Before touching any patient, I should wash. You see, I put gloves, sterilized gloves or examination gloves. So another way is to wash properly. And after that, to save yourself. After handling rubbish, when you deal with any rubbish thing, dirt or dust or get things which are cleaned off, or working in a garden from the soil, after handling animals like you pet, your pets or any other animal, you see on the street a horse, a cow, a dog, if you pet that or you deal with it, it is domestic or wild or whatever is there, so you must wash your hands. So these are the situations when you should wash your hands. Now how to wash your hands? So first of all, you wet your hands. Now there are 7 steps to it. So I will request my hospital staff to come and we will demonstrate the steps here one by one. Please come here. So these are the hands. Where are your hands? Okay. So now today we are a special this type of presentation from our Dewan Hospital, that wash your hands, clean your hands, save yourself from diseases. Speak. Wash your hands. Wash your hands. They can't speak. Today they have not taken food, right? Okay. So first step is to have water, right? To have water. You can see on the slide also, first step is to have water. Now second step is that you rub your hands palms together, palms together. So rub your palms together. So with the water, you have water and soap solution. So we forgot the soap solution. Wet your hands with water and have soap solution. And this is the first step. Have your wet your hand with water and have soap solution. And then the second step is wash, rub your palms. Rub your palms, rub your palms. Rub your palms, rub your palms. So this is the second step. Second step, third step is that rub the back of the hands. Rub the back of the hands. So don't forget this third step, rub the back of the hand. So then fourth step is that interlocking your fingers. Rub your hand with interlocking fingers like this. Again repeating, first of all have water and wet your hands, then have soap solution and rub the palms, second step. Third step, rub the back. Fourth step, rub your both hands with interlocking fingers. Now fifth step is rub the back of your fingers, so like this. Show on the this thing, rub the back of your fingers. Show like this, rub the back of your fingers. So this is that rub the back of your fingers, fifth step. And then sixth step is you rub the tip of your fingers. Rub the tip of your fingers. So that tip of your fingers is clean. After that, the seventh is you clean your thumb by the other hand and making a rotatory movement. Clean your thumb, and also your wrist. So the last step after this is that again from the running water of a tap, you clean your hands, wash your hands and remove all the traces of the soap. And then after that, you should dry your hands with a clean towel or a clean toilet paper. So this is that the demonstrated way of washing your hands, cleaning your hands. So the message is clean your hands, remove the germs, remain healthy. Thank you very much.